Hello and welcome to this tutorial on how to modify your juggling clubs and make them into magnetic juggling clubs. But first you might wonder, what are magnetic clubs and why would you want to modify your juggling clubs? And to answer this, I will show you some old footage from 2008 and also some footage from the older videos I made later in 2010 and 2015 with some different magnetic clubs in them. Anyway, here you go.
Det blev just den 1 januari och jag har gjort mig några käglor med magneter så att de sitter ihop så här alltså.
And well, of course, with magnetic juggling clubs, as well as any other juggling prop, your own imagination is basically what limits you from doing whatever. Like, well, of course, it depends on what kind of magnets you put in the club. And on that topic, let's first go over what kind of clubs you even can modify. Not every club is suitable for being modified. Most of the clubs with a wooden dowel inside are quite easy to modify, and you can do it in a couple of minutes, as I will show you later in this video. But there are some things that differ between most of the store-bought clubs. As you can see, Henrik uses screws which are a bit thinner than the other brands, so you can have a smaller hole and still make it work. And I will put some links in the description below for where you can get some of these countersunk magnets. Not every online store carries the correct size countersunk, and also magnets with different polarities. Here I put some different types of magnets on a plate to display for you. Down at the bottom here you can see some countersunk magnets which have a too small countersunk hole, which cannot be used with the normal screws like that I showed you earlier. And then on the side I have some magnets which have a good size countersunk hole and can be used in all the store-bought clubs with a wooden dowel and screws inside without too much hassle. Some are a bit more finicky to work with, but these magnets will work. Then there's the magnets I used in the original clubs, which are glued in, but the magnets are stronger because they don't have a hole in them. And then there's these really big magnets, which I used in some weird-ass clubs that are kind of weird, yeah. And then we see the different types of tools needed. And as you can see, I put some text in the top right corner here in the screen. And most of the tools I display are optional. You only really need a spade bit and a screwdriver to do this. Assuming you use the countersunk magnets after all and not the glue stuff, then you need a file to roughen off the surface of both the club handle and the magnet, and of course some really freaking strong glue. There is one more thing which is really important. The magnets you want, to be very clear, need to have different polarities on the side which has the countersunk, and then you need to think about the configuration that you actually want to have the clubs in. I've done two main ways. The first way, which I had on the original clubs, is to make each club have two magnets with the same polarity. And then on the next club, have the alternate polarity. So north-north on the first club, then south-south on the second club. And then on the third club, north-north again, and then south-south on the fourth, and so forth. This means that in practical terms is that once you have two clubs in your hands, one in each hand, they will connect in every direction with each other. Like you can connect them nose to nose, handle to handle, nose to handle, handle to nose. You can turn them around like this and they will all work. If you were juggling with three clubs and you throw one high and try to connect the clubs you have left in your hands, if chance would have it like so, that you would throw the only south pole club up in the sky and you have only two North Pole clubs left in your hands, then you can't connect them at all, no matter how you turn them. It seems simple to counter by having color-coded clubs, but question is if you want that. Most people that perform seem to prefer the second method, which is to only put North Pole magnets in the nose and South Pole magnets in the handle, or vice versa. It has the same effect. It means that, in practical terms, that it will only work to connect them handle to nose. But it will always work. You don't have to think about which club you have left in your hands or anything like that. We can cover briefly that there are other options available. You could, for example, drill out a countersunk in a stack of washers, or use an iron nut and screw into the club. Then you have a metal club as the third club. And then you can have three clubs that will all connect to each other no matter what. Like, you can turn them either way and you don't have to think about anything. But there is a downside to this as well, and that is that iron clubs with just a stack of washers will not be able to connect to anything metal in your environment or on your body or anything like that. There is also another type of magnet, which is called a diametrically magnetized magnet. But you have to turn them, twist them, to make them connect. And also, it is relatively weaker than axially magnetized magnets. But with that in mind, there is so many different configurations possible. So now it's time to start modifying. You start simply by removing the protective foam knob that covers the screw in the nose of the club. This can be done with any sharp, pointy object. Then you unscrew the screw, which is underneath the foam. And before going to the handle and unscrewing the knob, just place the magnets into the club and put the screw back in. If it's needed, you can use the spade bit to remove more material from the top of the club. Once you put in the magnet, you just screw it back in. Make sure the screw is flush with the magnet and the foam. Once you're done with the nose, you simply move on to the knob in the handle, unscrew that. Then it's time for the hardest part, and that is to remove the material from the knob. And the only reason it's hard is because you can accidentally drill too deep and make the hole straight through. Then you have to kind of glue it back on. Or just buy new knobs and try again. Be sure to hold the drill straight so it doesn't like jump off the knob and hit drill into your hand or anything like that. So if you're unsure on how to use it, try to find a vise so you don't have to hold it with your hand. It's also an alternative to make it safer. Or simply take the spade bit and use it by hand. Since it's like foam you're drilling into, it's very soft and you can easily make a hole in it, holding the spade bit in your hand. As I show you here, it's very quick. It's almost as quick as using the power tools. So by putting your thumb and your index finger into the hole on either side of the hole, you can kind of judge how much more material there is before you make the hole straight through. And if you need to make more room for the magnet, you can drill a bit more. I mean, simple as that. If you drill too far and the magnet is too deep in the knob in the handle, you can, just as with the top of the club, you can put some spacers in. I would suggest iron washers, so that way you make the magnets a bit stronger as well. Well, that's how you do it. It's as simple as that. Now when you're finished, make sure again that the screw heads are completely submerged in the countersunk part of the magnet, so the magnets when attached to each other will be completely flush. Then you should be good to go. Alright, so that about sums it up. It's very simple, as I said, and if you have any other questions, feel free to leave some comments and ask me, and I will do my best to answer. Also, I will put in some extra tips and tricks here in the end of the video. There are some things that can happen, and I will show you. It's some troubleshooting, basically. So, you throw your club after you finish modifying, and it's all rickety, and it makes some weird sounds and feel kind of weird, you know? chances are you missed the dowel when screwing back the screw in the nose, which is easily remedied. But it's also, well, it's kind of easy, but it's also one of the trickiest parts if you did mess it up. But you should remove the magnet and everything from the nose, get a good light overhead, and look into the club and see if you can spot the hole in the dowel, and try to adjust it so it's centered above the hole in the foam. And then put the magnet back in and, like, without wiggling the club around, screw it back in using your fingers, and then once you feel that it gets a grip in the dowel, you use a screwdriver and finish the job. And then there's the simple advice of handling the magnets, which can be quite frustrating. And I would suggest using some piece of metal which is magnetic to put the magnets on, and arrange them so that you can safely handle them without them slamming together, because the magnets can break when they do this. And that's about it. I want to give a big shout out to the doc students that took up magnetic clubs in their acts. There are a lot of you, so I salute you. It's been such an honor for me to know that these ideas I have are touring the world in some fashion. Very fun. Thank you so much. Also, thank you, Jay Gilligan, for making the workshop donut doc possible, and also for your own work with magnetic clubs. It means a lot to see all this nice stuff happen. Thank you.